What's up everyone and welcome to another video of Grandmaster Chess Openings. In today's video we're going to have a look at the Slav Defense, which I will teach you in a very concise and easy to understand way. If you want to learn more openings like this, make sure to subscribe and let me know in the comments down below what opening you would like to see next. So the Slav Defense arises after the move d4. You're going to play the move d4, d5. And if I play c4, the Queen's Gambit, we're going to respond to that with the move c6. The idea behind the move c6 is to keep this pawn on d5 well protected, but we also still want to be able to develop this bishop. So if you're a London player, this opening is going to fit you very well. Now, what you will often see here is white developing the knight to f3. You're going to respond to that with knight f6. And let's say white plays the move e3. Here, if you're a London player, you're going to be very happy. You're going to play the move bishop to f5. Now let's say white plays knight to c3, you're going to play e6. And as soon as we have played the move e6, if white ever takes on d5, you're going to recapture with the e-pawn, because the half-open e-line will very often come in useful for black. So that's important to remember. Now let's say white plays a move like bishop to d3. What you want to do here is you want to drop your bishop back to g6. So in case white ever takes on g6, we're going to recapture with the h-pawn, opening up this file for our rook. But let's say white castles. The setup you want to remember here is you want to develop your knight to d7. Let's say white plays b3. Here you're going to develop your bishop to the d6 square. So let's say white played bishop to b2. Here, black has done a good job of developing all of his pieces. We have a pawn in the center. It's well protected by the pawns here. We have the knights on f6 and d7, a bishop on g6, and a bishop on d6. But here's where a lot of players struggle, right? You've developed all your pieces, but what are we going to do now? The plan you want to remember here is the move knight e4, because this move is very annoying for white. White can never take with the knight, because then you're going to recapture with the pawn, and you have a fork. And white can take with the bishop, but here we're also going to recapture, and we hit the knight on f3, which we'll have to move, and now we see that the white king does not really have any defenders anymore. So here we're first going to play f5, defend the pawn on e4, and next up we have ideas like queen h4 to go after the white king. So let's say white plays a move like queen c2, putting more pressure on the knight on e4. Here you want to play the move f5, so in case white takes now, here we're going to recapture the f-pawn, and this is even better because we always can use the half-open f-line to attack. But let's say white continues developing with a move like rook a to c1. Here what you're going to do is we're just going to castle. And after a3, here what you want to do is you want to put your bishop on h5, bring the bishop back to life, putting pressure on the knight on f3. And next up we're going to play rook to f6, rook h6, with a big attack for black. Alright, so these are the plans you have to remember if white allows you to bring out the bishop to f5. Alright, so let's go back. Now let's have a look. So let's say white plays knight to c3. We play knight f6 and white plays e3. Here you can also play the move bishop f5. And very likely things will transpose. Let's say white goes knight f3. We're going to play e6 with a position we've already seen before. All right. Now let's have a look at what we should do if white plays the exchange Slav. Not the most exciting line, but it's very important to know what to do here anyway. So we're going to recapture with the c-pawn, and notice that now the c6 square has opened up for our knight. So let's say white plays knight f3, we're going to play knight f6. Let's say white plays knight c3, we're going to play knight c6. And if white plays bishop to f4, we're going to play bishop f5. And let's say white plays e3, we continue with e6. All very solid. Next up we're going to develop the bishop to e7 or to d6. We're going to castle, and black doesn't really have much to worry about. We have solid development. All our pieces are active. It's just important to remember that you never want to play the move e6, because now your bishop on c8 is going to be passive. Once again, that's the main idea of the Slav. We want to bring out this bishop to f5. Now, let's have a look at what you should do if white plays, let's say, knight c3, knight f6, and bishop g5. This is what I see happen quite a lot at lower levels, and this move is actually a mistake, because here you're going to capture the pawn on c4, and once again this is why the Slav is a tricky opening. If white plays the move e4 trying to get his pawn back, here you're going to play b5, And suddenly it's very difficult for white to get the pawn back, because here all these pawns are nicely protecting each other. And black is just very often going to be a pawn up. So if white brings out his bishop early, you're going to take this pawn here. Now, if white plays, let's say knight f3, knight f6, and knight c3, this is what I call a two knight attack against the Slav. Here, I would not recommend the move bishop to f5. Because if you play bishop f5, white can take on d5. And if you recapture, white's going to play queen to b3, hitting the pawn on b7, and we do not have a comfortable way of defending this pawn, because if we play a move like, let's say, queen to c7, this pawn on d5 is now hanging. So you can try getting away with the move bishop to f5, but the higher you get, you will see more and more players playing c takes d5 and queen to b3. But I guess it's up to you to see how far you can get with this move. But the move I would recommend is, once again, the move d takes c4, because you will see a lot of players go here e4 with white, which you're going to respond to with the move b5, once again creating this pawn clump on the queen side, and it's very difficult for white to get the pawn back. If white plays a move like bishop to e2, white has a nice center, but we're a pawn up. So we're just going to play a move like e6, and if white castles, you're going to play bishop to b7, just continuing your development. So let's say white plays a move like bishop b3. We bring in the knight to d7. And if white ever plays a move like e5, you're just going to go knight to d5. And if white takes, well, that only helps us, because here we undouble our pawns and we're just a clear pawn ahead. But if white does not play e5, next up you're going to play bishop to e7, castle. And once again, we're up a pawn. It's up to white to show the compensation. So yeah, that is really all you have to know in the Slav system, in the Slav defense. Once again, very often you want to bring out your bishop to f5. So yeah, hope you all enjoyed the video. Make sure to like, leave a comment below. Let me know if there's any, if you have any more questions, or if there's anything I did not cover. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.